Yes, I'm serious. This is Farming Simulator 2013. And I'm also serious when I say that this is one of the most enjoyable, satisfying virtual experiences that I have had in 2012. I'm not kidding. It really is. I'm not kidding about not being kidding either. This is seriously enjoyable. So anyway, this was recently gifted to me on Steam by Ben. Thank you very much, sir, for gifting me this and a bunch of other stuff, but this was the first one I went to because, well, as you may have figured out by other videos that I've done, Fly Simulator, Train Simulator, I like weird niche simulators, and that's just sort of evolved out of my love of the Maxis Sim games, Sim Ant, Sim City, Sim Farm. In fact, this kind of reminds me a good bit of Sim Farm. Anyway, I like those, and this seemed intriguing, and I've already put like 15 hours into it in the past 2 days. I can't stop playing. All right, so this is a game by these guys, Giants Software. Apparently they're based in Switzerland, although I think they have a presence in Germany as well, and published by Focus Home Interactive. And I think these are the same people that also did one of the previous farming simulators, of course, as well as a demolition company and like ski resort simulator. I don't know how those are. I guess maybe they're okay. They haven't sold nearly as many copies as this. And yes, this is selling actually quite well. I think it sold like 500,000 units in the first week or something crazy. It's like outselling Medal of Honor Warfighter overseas, like in Europe and UK and such. Just pretty crazy. And I honestly don't blame the fan base because I am now definitely one of them. So let's go ahead and go right into this. Options are pretty scarce. That kind of sucks, but whatever. It's not a graphical powerhouse kind of game. So, yeah, whatever. There is pretty extensive modding support. I have a handful of mods installed, which is nice. This is definitely one of those games you'll want to mod more stuff in to really customize your experience. And, of course, like any good simulator, there are a crap ton of controls. Blah! Tons of them. Although, really, you can control pretty much all of the game with a handful of them. You know, the mouse and, like, the left half of the keyboard. Or with a gamepad, if you want to. It works pretty well with a gamepad as well. You get some tutorials, which really only cover basic usage of some of the equipment. Doesn't actually cover how to farm things, like, you know, when to grow, what to use, how all that works. I would highly recommend looking up some online tutorials. There's some on YouTube that are great. The forum is great. The community for this is actually fantastic. I've received a lot of help from them already. It's bizarrely active and quite friendly. Also has a multiplayer mode, but I haven't tried that yet. I hear it's pretty awesome. Well, you know, as awesome as multiplayer farming gets. Anyway, let's go ahead and go into a career. As you can see, I have one here. This is a 7-hour farm I've got going at the moment, but I've done like 10 of them. I just keep deleting and starting over. Let's just start a new one though here on easy. These three difficulties mostly just change what you start out with and how much money you earn from your starting map. And of course you have multiple ones to choose from, at least if you have more than one downloaded. You only start with one originally, but yeah, the difficulty modes, I play on easy because honestly the harder ones tend to just make the game a lot more grindy. You know, you have more, it's like, it's not any harder, it just takes longer to do stuff, and that's not exactly how I want to play. Anyway, so yes, as you can see here, you start off in a first-person kind of mode, so unlike something like Sim Farm, or, well, kind of like Harvest Moon even, well, you know, unlike Harvest Moon, you don't have that sort of top-down sort of thing going on. You know, it's got a lot of strategy elements, but it's not like a strategy kind of game. It's like if you took something like Sim Farm and put it down to the level of The Sims, or even GTA. You'll see what I mean in a minute. Man, I got some nice underwear. I guess that's my underwear. Oh yeah, this is your house, although, yeah. It's not going to be like Harvest Moon where you have, like, people to go into the town and, like, marry, and there's no story and there's no talking with anyone. It's just you and a farm simulating things. All right. So at the beginning, you start off with the... It's actually a pretty nice little place. It's pretty generous with the equipment it gives you, too. You have a selection of tractors. You know, old crappy ones to slightly less crappy newer ones. You get trailers, you got a seeder and a cultivator and a plow. And there's a combine harvester out there in the field. That's pretty much it. So let's just hop into one of these tractors. Let's go into this one because it sounds cool. So maybe you see what I mean by the GTA kind of aspect of it. You know, it's not like The Sims or something where you click on something and have it go there or whatever. No, you're actually in the vehicles, you know, or you get out of the vehicle and go into this one. You're controlling them very much hands-on. And I like that. It really helps the immersion of this kind of thing. You know, it's not as hands-off as Sim Farm was or even something like The Sims is, so... Pretty cool. Alright, so at the beginning here, you'll see here's the combine over there. See, I have a field that I'm running over and not damaging somehow of wheat. I guess it's wheat. Let me see. It is wheat. Yes. So you see on the map here, let me turn this stupid tractor off to make a noise. Alright, see on the map here, you have this big open world to explore, and all these little plots of land are yours if you buy them. The whole point of this really is to be successful, buy more land, to be more successful, to buy more land. Endless circle. It's an open-ended, sandboxy kind of simulation. Yeah, there's no real goals, no end game, just kind of make of it what you will. And I like that. You see all the different vehicles that you can get into. I have some tractors just sort of scattered all over the place. If you want to, you can click on them and just jump to wherever you want to be. Like here we have some like a dairy thing for you can raise cows in here. Yes, there's livestock. It's not just crops. We can just switch around to different things. There's not as much livestock as I would like. You have chickens and cows and sheep. I think that's it. And none of it's for meat. You know, sheep's for wool, chickens for eggs, cows for milk. Let's just go ahead and get into the combine here. And pretty much just show you what you do. So, yeah. As you can see, there's nothing attached to it. But I do have attachments available. So if I were to go over here, there we go. I'm just attach that. And you can see at the top left, I have some different controls. So if I want to turn on the harvester. Yeah, let's lower it. And we can harvest the crap out of this wheat. Though you don't harvest crap from wheat. You harvest wheat from wheat. So let's wheat this wheat. Oh yeah. The chaff coming out the back and all that crap. It's awesome. You can even honk the horn. And there you go. Now, this thing will fill up with the wheat eventually. So, what you can do is either control it manually like this, or if you want to, you can hire workers. So I just press H, and it will hire an AI worker to work this field. So what I can do is... I need to get rid of those stupid tractors. I'm going to get this one out of the way. And go get one of the other tractors. And come over here so I can actually get the wheat while that guy is going along, sucking it up, harvesting and all that crap. And that way he won't fill up before he fills up. What am I saying? Basically, I don't want him to stop working. I want that guy to work hard. After all, I am paying him. Ah! Oh, yeah. So here we go. I'll just be able to, wait for him to turn around. Go up alongside of him, and he'll stick that little pipe arm thing out and start tossing wheat into here. There we go. So, you excited yet? This is actually incredibly addictive. At least it is for me. I know this is not going to be for everyone, and I completely understand. But let me put it this way. Before this, I was playing Call of Duty Black Ops 2, and I was almost bored to tears. I mean, it's okay, and it's flashy, and, you know, blockbustery explosions, and yeah, I'm a man. But this makes me feel more manly than that. I mean, I'm growing my own stuff here. And, you know, diesel tractors and, yeah, working with my hands. Well, working with my fingertips on a mouse and keyboard, but whatever. Point is, if you like simulations, if you like the idea of something like Sim Farm, but want it to be a little more hands-on, then this is actually, I mean, pretty freaking awesome. So as you can see here, I have different silos, and what I'm just going to do is go over here and unload. All right, put that crap in there. I'm going to bring up my PDA here. You can see the weather forecast, stuff that's, we've got the different things in storage there. So that's the stuff that you have on hand. So really the whole idea of this is to play the economy to your advantage. So, let's see, as you can see here, there are different prices for different locations around the map. So, if I were to take, say, canola to the freight yard, I could sell it for $20.78 per ton. Whoops. And if I were to take it to the mill, it'd be $19.70 per ton. So, different places will want different commodities for different prices at different times. So you constantly want to look through here, and occasionally you get something like a great demand, so they're really going to pay a lot for it. Those are what you really want to watch out for. Of course, you want to balance finances, though, just like in Sim Farm and everything like that. If you go over your financial whatever for the month, then you're going to end up in a hole. Of course, you have like loans. If you want to take out loans, you want to pay those off so you don't get too much interest, all that kind of stuff. It's very much one of those kind of simulators, and you know, it's much like SimCity in the respect that this should not be entertaining, but it is, and I don't understand. It's awesome. So let me just get out of here. Do I want to get out of here yet? Yeah, let's go ahead and get out of here. I'm going to go back to my actual save game here and show you what a farm looks like as it's gone along for a little bit longer. Yes. All right. So, yeah, let's just... Oh, this guy. What did you stop working for? There we go. Now, I've got this guy cultivating this field. And, as you can see, I have these two fields as well as this one now. And what I've actually done is combined the two separate fields into one field. So this part right here actually used to be a road. Not anymore. Now it's food. At least it will be. So yeah, you can combine fields. You can actually plow up this entire freaking place. Let me go ahead and show you that. It's actually pretty cool. Yeah, it's a surprisingly open-ended experience. You know, it is a sandbox, and pretty much everything can be screwed up. Except for the immortal trees and rocks and houses for some reason. Ah, the wheelie. So if I wanted to, theoretically, I could make a friggin' field right here. Oh, yeah. Ah, shut up. Oh, disconnected. Yes. Oh, looks like an Aperture Science logo.
When life gives you corns, you throw the corn back.
Yeah, if only you had explosive corn and sweet potatoes. Come to think of it, this could use some domestic terrorism. Maybe in a future DLC. Alright, that's enough of that. But anyway, as you can see there, you can pretty much plow up anything, make anything into a field. You can make crop circles if you want to. You can just go out there and not confuse the locals because they have no AI. I have a few other things in here. Let's see. Yeah, I've added a beehive. This thing is pretty much automatic. You got honeybees. They make honey. It sells it for you like every hour or something, and it's just something else to give you income. Same kind of thing with my chickens here. Oh man, they've laid eggs everywhere. Gotta collect the eggs. Shut up. Collecting eggs is kind of a pain. I wish they would like lay them in a nest like normal chickens. Well, actually, I used to raise chickens, and some of my chickens were stupid. Actually, all of them were, but some were more stupid than others, and they would lay them all over the place, like on top of the deck railings and stuff like that, but generally, they would lay them in kind of one area. You know, at least not all throughout the yard like this. But anyway, you can get these eggs and collect them, go downtown, into the city. In fact, let's do that. Alright, here we go. Oh look, it's one of the badly rendered people. What are you doing? What you doing, man? Apparently I'm a ghost. Oh no. Anyway, you can take them to these shops. Yay, money. Sell the eggs. Same kind of thing with milk and wool and whatever else. You take them to these places and sell them. That's really the gist of it. And what do you do with that money? Well, physics are kind of weird at times, especially with modded vehicles like this. Ah! Tractors are fine, modded vehicles not so much. Anyway, yes, what you can do is you can go to this vehicle kind of place here and buy more vehicles. You got tractors and front loaders and harvesters and potato harvesters, one of which is on sale for almost, good grief, too much friggin' money. Yeah, I mean, there's a bunch of stuff. Oh yes, you do have lawn mowing. I guess I was thinking of the game Lawnmower that I reviewed recently. Lawnmowering. So if you want to, you can actually go around and mow the world. There's a lot of world to mow. Really though, there's not a whole lot of reason to do that. I mean, unless you're just like one of those that likes mowing. There are also some random kind of, I don't know, I guess you call them missions. More like waste of time. where you can go and mow like the high grass at the local golf course or the campground or something. They'll pop up occasionally. Some of them are worth your time, some of them aren't. Like the front end loader ones are pretty much just a waste. They're just a waste. Lawnmower ones are okay if you're nearby, but otherwise, yeah, I don't know. I mean, I would rather focus on farming and harvesting or whatever, but I get, you know, it's handy at the beginning when you don't have a crap ton of stuff to do. And yes, you can you can pretty much go anywhere in these friggin' tractors. They are surprisingly resilient creatures. Yeah. I gotta say, the physics are quite forgiving in Farming Simulator. hence why I was saying earlier the whole simulation aspect of it really doesn't make much sense, because quite frankly the simulation is silly, but it gets the job done. It's a representation more than it is a simulation, which is good. I think if it were too abstract or too whatever, that it wouldn't be nearly as fun as it is. Oh, come on. What am I even stuck? Oh, great, yeah. Let's disconnect from that. There we go. You suck. Friggin' Bentley drivers. Or whatever that was. So there's the inn. It's one of the places that you can drop off different grains or whatever for sale. So that's cool. There's a lot of driving around. I kind of wish there were an easier fast travel system, because it does get really grindy just going back and forth and back and forth with a lot of these raw materials. There is sort of the fast travel thing where you can have different vehicles out there and then just teleport to them, like boom, like that. But that means you have to have a vehicle somewhere, and yeah. So look! I am mowing the grass! Oh, it's impressive. Yay! Any game that allows you to mow grass is impressive. It really is, and it pretty much automatically goes into my list of favorite games in some way or another. I mean, Lawnmower, Bully, this. So I'm sure there's others. Anyway, you can go and collect this grass and dry it out and give it to your cows or whatever. I think. I don't have any cows. Or you can just leave it there. You can also not run people over, which is what I will now attempt. Oh, stop going over there. Okay, here we go. I'm about to not run you over. Oh, no, I didn't run you over. Yeah, the collision detection leaves something to be desired, as does the fact that nothing gets damaged. You know, in fact, there's really not too many negative effects to anything at all. I mean, it's kind of disappointing in that respect. I would like it if there were at least the option for things to be a little bit more harsh. I mean, for one thing, there's not even really any... Oh, crap. There's not even really any disasters. And that's something that I liked in Sim Farm. I mean, that would really... It sucked. It'd screw up your day if, you know, you had, like, pestilence or a tornado or something. Whoa. But it was also awesome because, you know, hey, it's realistic and that crap happens and oh, my... Ah! About the only negative thing that happens here is, sometimes it supposedly rains. Oh, here's one of those stupid missions. This front loader was dumb. Yeah, sometimes it supposedly rains. I haven't actually seen it rain yet for as long as I've been playing. Or hail or something. Holy crap. Jeez, what the frick? But, physics are... Oh, the physics are so messed up with this thing. You do occasionally have your crops go bad, I guess. Again, I've never had that happen. But, yeah, I mean, it could stand to have some more negative consequences for, you know, being an idiot or not preparing or something. Because as it is, it's pretty much just, you know, plant stuff, harvest it, sell it. Repeat, repeat, repeat. Which is, like I said, oddly addictive and, yeah, just enjoyable. I mean, there's something peaceful about going out here and saying, yeah, this is my land. I'm going to cultivate this crap. I'm going to go over here and I'm going to seed it. I'm going to fertilize it. And then harvest it. Put it in something for a while. Sell it later. Get money. to get more stuff to do the same thing all over again. It's peaceful. It really is. It's one of those... I can't believe that I've spent 15 hours on it. I mean, it feels like I maybe spent a couple or something, but it's... I just look up and all of a sudden, time has passed. And it's weird. Oh, it's so weird. Screw you, we're gonna take control of your tractor. Mess up your efficiency. Let's go up here and see more of the world, because there is a lot. There is a lot. There's also random collectibles, like if you get the urge to just go exploring. I don't think we're gonna be able to make it. Well, I can though, because I am a goat. In fact, I think you can actually... Yeah, I tell you how realistic that is. You can just walk right up to the top of these things. At least you can if you go up the right side of it. There we go. Definitely not supposed to be able to do this, but, you know, you get bored. That's another thing this could stand to have, is more leisure activities. I mean, my family, or at least one half of the family, runs a farm, or ran a farm. We still have it, but, you know, it's kind of there now. And, you know, I mean, ah, frick, screw that. Leisure is a big part of it. You don't just farm all the time. There's other things to do. It'd be nice if there were, like, hunting or fishing or... Well, those are pretty much the two biggest things. I mean, that would be awesome to just go out here and be like, okay, you know, crops are growing. That's cool. Let's go out here and get some rabbits and squirrels and eat them. Or even be able to go inside your house, you know, you can't do that. Or even in, like, Sim Farm where you could grow, like, prized animals and enter them in contests downtown, that'd be cool. Yeah, there's always more things they could add. But in a way, the simplicity of this is also its strong point, because you don't have all of that other extra fluff getting in the way. You know, there's not really any cosmetic stuff to get. You're not going to be customizing your guy's overalls or something or anything like that. It's just you and the land and your crops. Yeah, buddy. There's a full day and night cycle as well, although it will last quite a while. As you can see here, I have the time scale up to 15x, so you can go all the way up to 120, or you can even go down to real time. That is some hardcore simulation. Frick, real time growing of stuff. Oh, man. And you can change around plant growth, crop growth, mission frequency. And yeah, like I said, pretty much... Oh! Wanna fall over there? Pretty much open-ended to just play however you want. And then, of course, extend it even further with mods. There's not a ton of mods for this yet. Let's turn over. Yeah! It's my favorite thing to do. Tractor tipping. What? You get bored out here sometimes. Waiting for these crops to grow? Anyway. Yeah, there's not a ton of mods for it yet, just because the game hasn't been out for a really long time yet. But I expect there to be a ton because... I mean, just looking at the ones for, like, 2011 and stuff, yeah, there were a crap ton of mods. I mean, there are people running around in, like, you know, friggin' Lamborghinis and airplanes by the time people were done with this. So, yeah. Yunk. I will mow your tent down. Or no, I won't, because I can't. Never mind. Well, I'm trying to think. Is there really anything else to show here? Not really, because... Yeah, most of it really is just going to be... doing a lot of this over and over. In slightly different ways, you know. Just to liven things up a bit. Here... Is that gonna work? Alright, it will work. Okay. I like this thing because it's cool. Look at this. Oh, I got a freaking transformer on the back of my deal here. It's a monster. Oh, it just keeps going. How wide is it gonna get? It's gonna get pretty wide. I don't know why this crop out here screwed up. It doesn't seem to be maturing at all. I think I ran into a bug or something, because... Yeah, you don't have any actual bugs in the game. There's no insects, but you do have this. that kind of bug is not cool. Anyway. So this is what you would use to, like, spray or fertilize your crops. It's pretty cool. Near... Making weird designs and crashing into equipment. Yes. Okay. I guess I'm going to go ahead and call it a video because... I don't think there's much else I could really show, other than just maybe, like, dicking around in equipment. But that, you know, isn't exactly exhilarating either. Because once you figure out that the physics system is kind of broken, or, well, not really broken, but somewhat awkward for anything other than tractors, then, yeah... Oh, I do have a golf cart here. I stole this from the, literally stole it from the golf course. Golf carts, man. Not just for golf. See how freaking useless that is. Oh, man. Let's see if we can get it unstuck. Yeah, kinda. Woohoo! Yeah, this isn't a normal vehicle. I think I've already mentioned that it's a mod, but... Ah, dang it. It is useful for doing corkscrews in the air. No, it is useful for getting to one place to another quite quickly when you don't have something to teleport to. So, yeah, it has its uses even though it's an absolute pain to control. Oh, all right. Well, that is Farming Simulator 2013. A lot of fun, actually. I'm not entirely sure why. Yeah, like SimCity, like SimFarm, I don't think I can really explain it to you, but yeah, if you recall the feeling that those can provide of that satisfaction and the reward of a job well done and resources spent wisely, it's just gratifying. Even without 360 no-scope dubstep trailers. So yes, thanks for watching.